jeez. All right. It has been a dog's age, but this is gonna be fun. I was talking to a buddy of mine, Josh, and he could not stop talking about this. There he is now. So I'm about to experience an experience I never thought I would dream of wishing to experience. I am going to play it easy because I'm a total noob. And there's no HUD, and I also turned down the brightness.
Stephen King once wrote that nightmares exist outside of logic, and there's little fun to be had in explanations. They're antithetical to the poetry of fear. In a horror story, the victim keeps asking why, but there can be no explanation, and there shouldn't be one. The unanswered mystery is what stays with us the longest, and is what we'll remember in the end. My name is Alan Wake. I'm a writer. I've always had a vivid imagination, but this dream unsettled me. It was wild and dark and weird, even by my standards. So yes, it began with a dream. Following a typical nightmare pattern, I was late, desperately trying to reach my destination, a lighthouse. For some urgent reason, I couldn't remember. I'd been driving too fast down a coastal road to get there.
Turn that off. Options. I do not want commentary. That's weird. Sorry, man. I like you mentioned that the place is called Bright Falls. Yeah, I love how in this chapter Nightmare or whatever, it's called Night Springs, which is like the opposite. That's interesting to me.
Something important waiting for me there.
I also liked how when it showed the name of the game, it was the backdrop for the letters was water. Oh shit, what the fuck? Oh. Oh. Oh shit. I gotta keep fucking going. Oh God. Run, Ellen! Oh Jesus Christ. This is too soon. You can dodge. I can dodge. Ugh.
You can't stop me.
Try it again. Why? Ah! Look!
I realized that the hitchhiker was a character from the story I grew up on.
Yeah, I just noticed it. What do you mean? Oh no! Oh God! Alan, sir, you need to run faster. I know you're tired, but, like, goddamn! Oh, a guy! Hold on, this is really loud. Turn it down. No, effects. Speech is important. Just the music. Resume. Oh my lord, I cannot talk over this. It's so loud. But, oh my god. Oh, that's interesting.
Stop! No! David, die! No! No! No!
I was trapped. There was no way out.
Oh! Hello! That's a lot of time. What? Does that no? Holy fuck! Come on! I can't go that way. That way's got Buddy in it. Come on. Calm the fuck on! Oh god. Come on! Crazy motherfucker!
Follow the light.
I'm trying! Oh god. I can't.
You are hurt. You should go into the light. You are only safe there.
I'm only safe there. You're right. Oh god.
Well done. I have something important to tell you. It goes like this. For he did not know that beyond the lake he called home lies a deeper, darker ocean green, where waves are both wilder and more serene. To its ports I've been. To its ports I've been. Do you understand?
No.
Follow my light.
Sorcery. Witchcraft.
When it fills you clean, it will wake up. There's no time. I can only show you the most important thing.
What's this? Revolver ammo.
You can't hurt him now. The darkness protects him from all harm. Only light can drive the darkness away and make him vulnerable again. Here, take the light.
Take light.
Flashlight toward him and burn the darkness away. You did it. Now the darkness no longer protects him, but it's still in. He's still a threat. He is still your enemy.
Here, he can't be saved. Jesus.
Good. You've done well. Remember what I've taught you. That is all. I will give you back your dream now.
Thanks.
In the nightmare, a terrible darkness was taking over the world. The lighthouse was the last safe place on Earth.
What the hell? You aren't holding L2. Okay. Oh. Oh, shit. No! Woohoo! Get fucked, nerd! float like a butterfly, sting like a revolver. Ooh.
Ooh!
Some stuff. Oh, hello. Oh, hello there. So that's how you... Okay. Oh, jeez. Yes. Yes. Holy crap. That was sick. Oh god. Run, Mr. Wake. Oh, I'm gonna fucking get you though. Yeah. Says who? Oh. One. Oh, shit. Dude, the flare gun is so good. Holy.
I can keep this up.
Hey, not go that way. Ah! Yeah. Holy shit. Gotta get to the door. Oh my god. Oh my god. Yes. Oh my god. It's so nerve-wracking. Man, I honestly thought I was gonna get fucking killed by the tutorial. I honestly believed it. Don't start your conspiracy bullshit, man. Honestly. Save that for when we're, like, actually in voice chat so I can hear it. Oh, dude, wait. You can voice chat with me, can't you? Oh, yeah, you could just, like, party chat. The stream would hear you, but like you could go on with all your ideas and theories and stuff. I want a shot of town in the
background. Sure, I'll even give you a title for the shot: a city boy, moments before he got eaten by a bear. Hi. Hello there. You picked a good time to visit our town. Deerfest is just 2 weeks away. Deerfest, huh? Did you hear that, honey?
Ooh.
You have a lovely wife. Now, if you don't mind me saying, I'm Pat Mayne, by the way. Nice to meet you.
Yeah, I'm Alan Wake.
I won't pretend I don't recognize a famous writer such as yourself, Mr. Wake. A pleasure. I'm an avid reader myself. I hope this isn't too presumptuous of me, but I'm the night host at the local radio station. Any chance that you get a little...
Look, Mr. Mayne, I'm on vacation. In fact, I'd appreciate it if we could keep my being here just between the two of us. I'm sure you understand.
Fair enough. You can trust me to be this way. Not a hard man to track down if
was thoughtful.
Very nice. I got a couple of really good ones. So you made a friend. That's cute.
Right. Yeah?
Hey, bestseller. How's my favorite writer? Are you there yet?
Barry. Yeah. We just got here.
Are the locals giving you trouble? Just say the word and I'll hop on a plane and come make sure that you're left alone, Al.
No, Barry, we're fine.
Great. Great.
Just settling in.
Okay, Al. I'll call back later to make sure you're doing okay. And you call me if there's a problem, okay? Okay. Just looking out for you, buddy. Talk to you later.
I love you too, Barry.
You know he's going to be calling you every 5 minutes.
Barry is Barry. I can always turn off the phone.
What did I tell you?
Text message from Barry. He says hi to you too.
We're here. Come on, let's get back to the car.
What? Is this not the car? This is totes the car. Come on. And look at this butte. God damn. Took all the logos off of it.
Yeah, sounds like you've got a lazy bastard for a husband.
Yeah, but I got a thing for him. Come on, you lazy bastard.
I'm trying! Is it this one? Oh, it's this one. I'm thinking of the one from the dream. Wait a minute, that car looks like the one from the nightmare.
I'm Mr. Carl Stuckey.
And nobody was in that before the cutscene started.
Huh?
It is so good, dude.
Thank you for coming with me.
I love you too. Go on. I'll promise to pay.
He'll try.
I'd forgotten there were still places like this.
Ah, shit.
Towns where everybody knew everybody.
Welcome to the Oh Dear Diary.
Yeah, dude, that is the nightmare car.
If you can help me. I'm looking for.
Mr. Wake. Alan, Wake. Oh, God.
I'm trying to think what it looks like. I think it's called a Mustang? Sec. I gotta
try the coffee. Just don't blame me when you fall in love.
Yeah, it looks like a vintage Ford Mustang. You have to leave.
Rusty here is no longer human. Nothing but black coffee under a thin layer of skin.
Yeah, that makes two of us.
I gotta try to go around.
Are you staying long, Mr. Wake? I can't believe it. I'm happy.
Do me a favor, Sonny! I could really use a tune right now. Coconut, number 6 in the jukebox. I'd do it myself, but both of my legs have gone to sleep.
Oh, it even shows the number 6 on it.
Circulation.
Sick.
Yeah.
Are you serious? Coconut again? You disgust me. Call yourself a rocker. Unbelievable.
It does that. Get stuck. You need to give it a good solid whack. Now that's what I'm talking.
This is it. I've died and gone to hell.
Ooh, a thermos. Delicious. The fuck?
You can hurt yourself in the dark.
I think I can handle it, ma'am.
I didn't want to wait. I wanted to find Stuckey, to get the key and get out as soon as possible. The waitress was giving me a headache. Overeager fans always did.
Hello?
Mr. Stucky?
Holy!
Unfortunately, he was taken ill. But I have the key for you and instructions on how to get to the lake.
Okay.
I wish you a good stay in my cabin. I'll come by later to check how you've settled in. And to meet your wife. I insist.
Thanks.
Cauldron Lake is a special place. Very inspiring.
Okay. This is supposed to be, what's her name?
I am so happy this could be arranged.
Barbara? Barb? What else do you have to say? Nothing. Okay. You know what?
You are not the first rider to stay in the cabin, you know.
Oh! How?
You're lucky this time, young man. You can hurt yourself in the dark.
I hadn't seen her leave, but the old lady was gone.
Did you ever check that, Josh? Come back to see if she was still there? And she only disappeared after Missy said that. She spoke.
Even that sounds better than your singing.
Are you alright?
Splendid, splendid! Damn.
The Andersons. They're, local musicians. We're waiting for Dr. Hartman to come pick them up. They wandered off from his clinic at the Cauldron Lake Lodge.
Bye, Mr. Wake.
Mission accomplished. The key and the directions.
My hero. I have some flashlights, just in case.
All right, I'll be right back.
Hey, wait!
Stiggy!
Mrs. Wake!
Stiggy!
Your keys!
That diner was a real nut house.
Can you believe this place? This would make a wonderful setting for a book.
We're supposed to be on vacation, Alice. I'll figure it out when we get back home, okay?
Oh, we can talk about
this.
I didn't want to talk about it. I wanted to bury my head in sand.
Here's another one of my favorites to go with it.
Once upon a time, I was a successful writer, but that was a long time ago. I hadn't been able to write a word in 2 years, not since my last book.
That's not a nod.
Wow. It's gorgeous, Alan.
It's something, all right. Don't worry, honey. I'll get you inside safe and sound before it gets dark. And I've got the flashlight.
I know. I'm okay.
Alice had a phobia. The fear of darkness. I wanted to make sure we were inside with the lights on before sunset.
It's actually a pretty common one. But this diver's aisle. See, I know that you told me a lot about the game, but
it's nothing like that for sure.
The apostrophe S means that the aisle belonged to a diver. And I know that, you know, from I've watched the review of it. And that Buddy looks like a diver? How intriguing is that?
inside. Sure thing. I'm on it. Hello? Anyone here?
Ooh! Yum. Yeah, it sounds like somebody upstairs. What the shit? Somebody wants to get hurt real bad.
The feel of the nightmare I had seen on the ferry returned. Damn.
Oh, look, there's the diver I was talking about.
I needed to get the power running in the cabin. There had to be a fuse box or a generator somewhere on the island. The cabin looked like a time capsule from the 60s, or even earlier.
Oh, I love how the light reacts with things. Maybe this way? Oh. Oh. I have to screenshot this. Holy shit, that's gorgeous. Where's the... Is it this way? No, it's not this way. Absolutely.
The island had once been the site for a love story. Maybe it would be that again.
Hmm.
An old generator had been connected to the power cable.
Beautiful is an understatement.
Alice had told me about Calden Lake Lodge. The old building used to be a hotel, but these days it was no longer open to the public.
But the lights are on.
Some time alone to think things through.
I noticed Missy show up just then. Like in a flash. Just stand there.
All the lights were out.
Alice! Alice! Where are you? Help! Alice, I'm coming! It's all right, I'm coming!
No!
What the hell?
Alan! Help me!
How did he end up here? Oh, I'll take this.
Among Alice's things was a book, The Creator's Dilemma, by a Dr. Emil Hartman. Seeing the book brought back my fight with Alice. I didn't like it, and I didn't like the guy's smug face on the cover either. Station was my best bet. They'd have a phone I could use. It looked like a long hike through the forest to get there.
Someone there?
The loose sheets of paper were pages from a manuscript entitled Departure. That was the name I planned to use for the next novel I had never gotten started. I was named the author. I hadn't written it. I couldn't remember writing it. In the scene on the page, the hero was attacked by an axe murderer in the woods at night. Departure by Alan Wake. The man turned to face me. His face was covered in shadows. It was hard to make him out in the darkness of the forest that surrounded us, but the axe he lifted was plain to see. It glistened with the blood of his victim. He grinned madly. The shadows were alive, distorting his features. It was a scene from a nightmare, but I was awake. lights up ahead were a good sign. Maybe I wouldn't have to hike all the way down to the gas station to find a phone.
Anybody there? Please, I've been in an accident.
Hey! Hey, you!
Phil!
There's been an accident. I need help.
Deposit.
Listen, I need to...
Premium cabins for rent in...
Oh, hell.
Carl Stuckey.
Pleased
to meet you. Non-refundable
reservation.
Deposit required. Fair and square.
Stood before me. It was impossible to focus on it, as if it stood in a blind spot caused by a brain tumor and eye disease. It was bleeding shadows like ink underwater, like a cloud of blood from a shark bite. I was terrified. I squeezed the flashlight like my life depended on it, willing it to stop coming any closer. Suddenly something gave, and the light seemed to shine brighter.
No. Oh, man. Look at this ninja! Get the hell out. Get the hell out. Wait, where's the tractor that moved it?
The bulldozer had gone over the cliff.
Oh.
I hoped Stucky had suffered the same fate, but I wasn't planning on staying to find out.
Holy fuck. Oh, thanks, Dor.
My head pounded with a concussion. I'd never fired a gun outside a shooting range, and now I just killed someone. Or something.
Oh, look at that!
They just disappeared. If I was dreaming, it felt real enough to make me sick.
The There's some arrows. What the
Dirty
hell?
Hand-painted graffiti was revealed by my flashlight. Someone had hidden a chest of supplies near it.
Jesus. That's cool. I'll take as much as I can get, thank you very much. Aha! There we go. That's promising. I'm really enjoying the fact that the field of view isn't for Alan. The field of view is the flashlight.
The dark forest was the last place I wanted to go, but I had no choice. I had to get to the gas station.
Whoa! Oh shit! This is the wrong weapon. Oh no. I meant to have the revolver out. Damn it. Like that. Check it out. What do we got here?
Rose knew she had been gushing, but right now she didn't care. As far as she was concerned, her brief meeting with Alan Wake was literally the high point of her life. She watched as he got in the car with his wife. She was pretty, confident, at ease with Wake. Not like Rose. They were perfect for each other. She'd have given anything to be called their friend.
Oh, yeah, that's right. I just do that. Huh. Okay, well, that's good to know. I'll pay more attention to it then. Let's watch out for that live wire. Oh, Jesus. A point of no return. Guy, we're gonna find out it probably.
When I saw the river below, something uncoiled itself inside my head. I realized that I'd have to find a way across. I didn't even want to look at the water.
What's over here? Ooh, coffee. I don't know if this is the right way to go or not, but... Oh. Whoa! What was that?
Stucky was still out there, in the dark, stalking me.
Oh, man. Oh. This is crippling atmosphere, holy shit. I do not know what to do. Oh snap, dude. I can totally get that. Come on. You can do it. There you go. Attaboy. Alright. Now, over to this. Over here. Yeah, there we go. Wrong button. There it is. Bring it.
Wheeler was bouncing off the walls. He jumped on a plane after his calls were ignored by both Al and Alice for several days. It could mean that they were both on a second honeymoon. But Barry didn't buy it. Al had been way too unstable for that. Not sleeping, messed up. Barry had years of experience dealing with Alan Wake, and he couldn't ignore it. Something was wrong.
Shit. Okay. Come on, you can do it. There you go. Look at the lighting effect from the flashlight, dude. God damn. You throw your axes. That's cool. Not yet, nah. That's not okay. Up and up. Proceed at your own risk. Well, what? Oh. I mean, look at this. The reflection on the sign causes... Oh, it's not happening now. It was like everything else got darker for a second there. Yeah, like, look at that. Because of like, how the flash, like, the lighting effects happen. Like, oh my god. Oh my god, that's... Oh my god. I don't even know words for that. It's just so incredible. Oh, up here. What is up here? Mr. Light. Light. Arrows.
Taken. They're taken.
Taken are filled with darkness. You can hear breathing. Oh man, that's unsettling. Nope. Revolver, please. That hurt me. No. Excellent. This way. Yes, man. Like, holy fuck. This takes, like, flashlights to a whole new level. Look at this. Look at this. Oh my god. Dirt. So good.
The staircase was broken. To make my way up some other way.
Okay, well, let's use flashlight Jesus's power, shine our flashlight on it, and then it'll rebuild itself. Oh, it's not working. I guess this flashlight's not bright enough. Rip. What do you got here? Some... Oh, I have full? Damn it. A pocket. It's too big. Pockets aren't big enough. I need deeper pockets. What was that? Ooh! A button.
There was no power. It was bound to be a generator somewhere at the logging site.
That's scary. I'm gonna try to avoid that. Ooh. That looks like a generator. Ho! Oh, man. Oh, no! Oh! Meta! No. Oh my God.
Oh. Several around. There had to be something I could use to reach the top.
Tension is most definitely rising. Is there anything? Ooh. Fuck yeah! Goddamn shotgun! I'm all about that. What? Oh God. Oh. Gonna use the shotgun yet, though. Oh, okay. Ooh! I see something. Where's the... I saw that. Give me that. Delicious. How the fuck do I get up there? Ooh! Oh, hello there, ladder. Huh. I'm getting way too excited. Getting all fucking... Ha! Fuck gravity. I know that sound. Is there anything here? A couple of cans. Oh, hold on, there, light. Oh, this place.
Just outside for a breath of fresh air, and what a night. I know most of you are probably in your beds by now, but if you're still up and around, take a moment.
Like, oh my God. For a spell and
the weather's absolutely still. The sky is crystal clear.
Oh.
It's like the forest is quietly breathing along with
you. Oh shit, look at that.
I'm a night owl, and it's all nice.
Found another one. I'll take this. Thanks, whoever left that there. Much preach.
But here I am, and I'll keep you company all night long if I weren't.
Oh, that's good to know. Wrong button. God damn it. Oh man, look at the light over there.
The gas station was closer now. It's like welcoming in the darkness.
Is that where I had to go? Or is that where I have to go? Is that still Stucky? Jesus. Listen, Shadow Stucky, y'all need to get some chill. Oh, I don't like that. I don't like this. I need to get to the street. Holy shit! Listen here, you crazy fucker! Shit! Fuck! No! Come on, flashlight, do your thing. Kick this motherfucker's ass. Oh my god. Jesus. Oh, I have full batteries. That's all this does? Oh my god. That's Stucky, isn't it? I gotta take care of this one first. You're not Stucky. There's more. Oh, of course. There's always more. But there's a piece of paper over there. Oh, you sons of bitches! You sons of shadow-obsessed bitches. Deeper pockets, my guy. Oh no. Oh wait.
I heard them before I saw them, swooping down from the sky and screeching as they came. I spun around just as the cloud was upon me. For an instant, I stared into 100 dead eyes, black pearls glittering in the darkness. I raised the flashlight and the swarm exploded like fireworks. Feathers burned, turned into ash. I couldn't hear my scream above theirs.
I did not point my flashlight at them. I got attacked.
At first, I kept finding the pages as if by accident. The book I couldn't remember was either a terrible and true prophecy or an act of creation that had rewritten the world. I began to hunt the pages feverishly, for they held the answer to the mystery. With it, I could save myself. With it, I could save Alice.
Oh, wait. I missed one.
I stepped into the gas station's garage. It was dark and cold. The place was a mess. It looked like someone trashed the place, or that there'd been some kind of fight. Light spilled into the room through an open door at the back, and I made my way toward it. Without any warning, I was blinded by a bright light. An old portable TV on the shelf had come alive by itself. Impossibly, I could see myself on the screen, talking like a madman.
Oh, right, this way. Maybe. I would laugh so hard if this was the wrong way to go. How's that? Oh, it's a bird. What the shit? Oh, no. I want to see you move. Oh, the shadow effects in this are unreal. Oh, my God. That is superhuman fucking shadow effects. God damn. Especially with the flashlight. Whew. I keep seeing more and more things that are great about this. Oh no! I do need a hefty meal. I am starving, my dude. Where are you? Where are you? You son of a bitch? Oh, that's a lot of guys. That's a lot of guys. Alright, it's one. Alrighty. Thank the fuck. Excuse me? Oh, I don't feel comfortable with this. Oh, no. Oh, safe house. Yes.
Science. It bestows immortality on those who advance it to elevate all of mankind. Einstein, Sagan.
Oh, there we go. I can change my angle of view. Oh, I love it. This is gonna take a long time, I'm sure. I'll have to watch this later.
Ooh.
Oh yeah, that's right, I haven't used any batteries yet. Thank God. Ooh. What did I just turn off? Oh, this... Oh, what the fuck is going on? Oh. I have to not let that fall on me. Holy fuck. Faster than me. Is that batteries? What the fuck? What in the fuck? He's invisible. Oh. Jesus Christ. Holy fuck. I really need this pick-me-up. Holy hell. Oh, this is where I had to go. Sweet.
I recognized the parade float I had seen in Bright Falls when I first arrived with Alice. After the insanity I had just experienced in the darkness, the lights of the gas station felt comforting. At least for a moment, the sane world reasserted itself. The garage was a mess.
It looked like someone had trashed the place, or that there'd been some kind of fight.
Duh!
Alright. I'll keep writing. Outside, there's only darkness. Outside the cabin, outside the story, there's only darkness. I can feel the presence in the dark. Just now, I could smell a perfume in the room. I'll reach her, I'll fix it up. I'll bring her back. The story will come true. If I stop, she's lost.
I don't believe this. It'd been me on the TV, talking crazy. Was I losing my mind?
Can't lose something you don't have.
Rainbow Sheriff Station.
Ooh, spooky.
A candy colored clown they call the Sandman tiptoes to my room every night. Just a sprinkle of stardust and a whisper. Go to sleep, everything is all right. I close my eyes, then I drift away.
Oh, it's just gonna play the whole song? That's sick. Oh man. I think I'm gonna call it there.
I came to Bright Falls with my wife, Alice.
Thank you for coming here.
I can skip this. We got, what's this? You could, okay. So once it loads up, I'll cut it.
Honey, I'm home.
There's a goddamn thermos right there.
Worst weather I've ever seen.
But I'm gonna call it here. How do I save? Yes, farewell.